This is a demo of iJuggle 2.0 for the iPhone. iJuggle 2.0 is a juggling animator and siteswap generator. And if you don't know what siteswap is, go check out siteswap.org. It's basically a mathematical notation for representing juggling patterns. So let's take a look at this. So the first thing you'll see here is this juggler doing five ball pattern. And if you are familiar with juggling animators at all, you may notice that this juggler looks exactly the same as the guy from Juggle Master, and that's because I'm using Juggle Master code under the covers here. Let's take a look. Let's change some settings here. I'm going to have this guy do an 8-ball pattern. So there we have an 8-ball pattern. And we can also change the style. So let's take a look at an 8-ball Mills Mess pattern. And you know, that's pretty impossibly complicated. Well, it's not impossible, but we can slow it down to get a better look at it. Or speed it up with this nifty slider. Okay, let me just leave that in a normal setting. You can enter in any site swap you want here, so I'm just gonna put a regular 3-ball site swap. This is a common one, 441. You can mix and match the styles. So this is a 441 windmill. Let's just put this back on normal for now and take a look at the generator. So the generator, this tab on the left here, does the siteswap generation. The code that I'm using here is from a program called J2, which was written by Jack Boyce. It's a command line siteswap generator. And you can see there's plenty of options for you to choose from. I'm just going to go with the default for now. This is, you know, going to list a bunch of 3-ball patterns. So we hit generate. We see we found 36 patterns. And if we scroll to the bottom here, these ones that are starred, those are excited state siteswaps. What that means is that in order to go from regular cascade into this siteswap, you have to do some transition throws. And we can see what those transition throws are if we turn on the show transition throws switch. So now we regenerate these, and we can see that, for example, in order to go into a 6051 pattern, you have to throw a 44 first. Or something, you know, something of that sort. So if we click on any of these, we can actually see it animated. So I'm just going to click on this 6051, and we see that this guy's animating this pattern. So we can, let's see here. So this actually supports, you know, synchronous or asynchronous or passing and or multiplexing. And now the animator does not support passing, and I'll show you, let me just show you what happens when I generate some passing patterns. Okay, so here's a list of passing patterns, and it'll only list 500. If you go over that, it stops generating. So we can pick one of these guys. If I click on this, it's just going to show that it's an invalid pattern because the animator doesn't support that. It's a solo animator. But it's still handy to be able to generate these guys. What we can do is do some sync patterns, some synchronous patterns. So example, we click on this. You know, some 3-ball synchronous pattern. Here's a box. This is a common 3-ball synchronous pattern. Let's see here. So let's go back to async, and I'll show you some multiplexing. I'm gonna put a 3 here because I just want to do. Yeah, I don't want to have more than 3 balls in hand at any given time. So I'll just put a max limit on that, and I'm going to change the number of balls, because three ball multiplexing patterns are not really that interesting. Let's see, let's just do period five. So I'm just waiting for this to, okay, so here we go. So here we have a bunch of patterns. These are all excited state. That's why they have all these transitions in there. Whoop. And actually these ones are kind of lame. I don't particularly like these, mainly because they have all these twos or other throws that are the same. So either they're not throwing or you can't tell that they're multiplexing. Let me just, I think it would be more interesting if I just do ground state patterns, and then let's say exclude threes. I don't want any threes, I want higher number pattern, throws, I mean. So let's generate that. What do we got? So these are some interesting looking ones. They get kind of crazy. Can change the style here. So, and we can actually, you know, modify the side swap after we've generated it and started animating it. So since this is a period five side swap, I can just make this a 9, for example. And let's take a look at that. Of course, when it gets that many balls, they all look very similar, but you can see the 9s being thrown up there like that. Okay. So the other thing that I wanted to show is you can also mix the sync and async, or sorry, the synchronous and multiplexing together, or passing actually. So I still have multiplexing on. Let's generate these patterns. Let's do this one. Yeah. So kind of an interesting sync multiplex. So anyway, that's it. That's all I wanted to show. That is iJuggle 2.0.